We're on a roll, baby.
America first.
America first. America first.
If I would have known this was a Klan meeting, I wouldn't have taken this mother.
I'm a tenured professor of film at Newark University, where I went. I'm also artistic director of the film school. And I'm a cinephile. A lot of my films have been about American cinema has degraded and dehumanized people, not just black people. You could say that the women, Native Americans, gays. So in dealing with the film about the Klan, it was just natural to use Dewey Griffith's Bird for Nation and Gone with the Wind as examples of films that are considered some of the greatest films ever. If you go to American Film Institute's 100 Top Films, both of those films I think are in the top 10. I was in my first year, and when you graduated film school, we were shown Bird for Nation. And we were taught by professors how a great filmmaker Griffith was and the innovations and the stuff he did as far as cinema goes. But the socio-political aspect of that film was never discussed. It was never discussed that the KKK was dormant. That film brought a resurgence to the Klan. That film was shown in Woodrow Wilson's White House.
He loved it.
He says, like a ride of history with lightning. And so directly that film led to, because of the resurgence of the Klan, it led directly to black people being murdered, lynched, castrated, and whatnot. That was not taught. I'm a product of New York City public school, Brooklyn, New York, from kindergarten to high school. And I think the third or fourth grade, Gone with the Wind was reissued. We had a class trip to see Gone with the Wind. And
in New York.
In Brooklyn, New York. And those images of Hattie McDowell, Butterfly McQueen. I know nothing about my birth, no babies. I mean, that was very troubling to me. And there was no discussion about the imagery that I saw as a fourth or fifth grader. In school, so I automatically thought of putting those two films in Black Klan. We just knew that it would work. Beginning the film, which is one of the most greatest sequences in cinema, with Scarlett O'Hara walking through the dead and wounded Confederate soldiers. That's a great shot. I mean, I can't front. That's a great shot. And then Crane, and then all of a sudden the tattered stars and bars of the Confederate flag appears. Had to start with that. And then we wanted to have this Klan initiation turn into a screening of the film where people were eating popcorn and cheering and yelling.
They're watching the first superhero.
There you go.